I was very pleased to see that Channel 4 was giving Shane Meadows a chance to do a four-part series. I think his films are absolutely marvellous, and it was interesting to pick up on This Is England, because I'd enjoyed the film very much. I wasn't too sure about the first episode, but I definitely think it's picked up, and I was very frustrated to have missed the third, but hooray for Watch Again.
Well, I love The Inbetweeners because it's... I think the humour, even though it's based on like 17-year-olds in between sort of school and university, it's really strikes a chord with a lot of people. When I was sort of that sort of age, experimenting stuff like that, I thought it was really, really good. And I think it strikes a chord with everybody, that.
7 days broadcast last night on Channel 4 at 10 o'clock. I watched it for about 20 minutes, intending to give the whole programme a go, and really my concentration and my interest in the programme wasn't really consistent throughout. I found the people quite aggravating. I found that perhaps the way that people's personalities and people themselves have been picked, I felt it was a little superficial.
I thought the documentary on My New Brain was absolutely brilliant. It's concentrating on real life stories that people can relate to, and it's really enthralling. You got to see how this guy has completely lost every trace of his old self and has now got to learn how to be this completely new person.
Well, there are two programs which I watch consistently on Channel 4 now. One is The Daily Show, Jon Stewart's show, which I desperately wished that we had a British equivalent, because a lot of Jon Stewart's stuff is lost on me because I'm not that familiar with American television, but I loved his humiliation of Tony Blair. It was great. The other one is Jon Snow, who's been, I think, a hero of mine for very, very many years, and I think the quality of Channel 4 News, evening news, is terrific.
Come Dine With Me has got to be one of my favourite daytime programmes. It's brilliant. The narrator is amazing. I really want to find out who that guy is, because he's got the best voice and he's so sarcastic, and he makes the programme for me, I think.
Something I noticed was that Darren Brown had a new show coming on Channel 4. I'm not interested in Darren Brown. I found life interesting and curious enough by myself without seeing somebody stopping people and kind of doing tricks on them, so don't care much for him.
I think all Darren Brown programmes are extremely interesting, and each one very different, and he's pushing the boundaries of what can be done on television these days, and I just think it's brilliant.
I love watching The Big Bang Theory. It's just so funny. I like watching Sheldon Cooper, who is basically an astrophysicist who is very, very intelligent but has no people skills at all. So it's wonderful watching him try to interact with people.
I love Grand Designs. We watched that previously. Now, that's a really great programme. I'm really into creative arts, and it's just so cool, isn't it?
I thought the Amish programme was such an interesting idea. In some ways, it was so amusing the way the boys threw themselves into it and the girls kept praying. But in some ways, perhaps the range of situations they were put in were maybe a little bit extreme. But then it's an extreme religious way of life and so on. But I thought it was a very interesting idea, and tapped into an audience of young people as well as an audience of people interested in religious matters and so on.
I've been watching a few episodes of Celebrity Come Dine With Me, and it's sometimes the conflict is quite bad. There's some quite nasty people they have on there. All right, it's about winning the prize at the end of the day, £1,000, but some of the people they have together, it's like chalk and cheese, and I don't really like what they put together there.
Well, I think Channel 4 should keep Big Brother well finished. I mean, I think it's an absolute total waste of time. Loads of people, or six, seven, I don't even know how many people, sat in a room doing nothing most of the time, and people are sat at home watching them. Have they not got a life to live? I mean, why have they got to sit there watching television? People sat in the room doing absolutely nothing.
After watching the Richard Dawkins programmes, I mean, it was very good. I enjoyed it. It kind of offered a really good scientific insight, although I did think that because he had such a steadfast opinion going into the programme about how religion was really a myth rather than ideal, that it could have been less biased than it actually was, that it was very informative and interesting.